Hi, in this video we'll go over defining and running XAFS scans, especially using an X-ray fluorescence map and points from that map at the X-ray microprobe beamline for GSE cars. Hi, I'm Matt Newville, one of the beamline scientists at the GSE cars X-ray microprobe beamline, and this is part of the series on showing you how to use the applications to run the X-ray microprobe beamline. In the previous video, we ran and defined and visualized X-ray fluorescence map of a garnet sample with some yttrium and some zirconium zircons throughout. And now we'd like to go to some of the points on this high yttrium band and measure the yttrium SANES or XAFS on that band. As I showed you in the last video, we saved some points. So I might save another one just to be complete. This is now the complete map. I've finished building it and built it. I might say let's call this spot 5 just for completeness, and I hit return. Again, that saves that to the map and writes it to the position list. So now I'll go over here to the X-ray, to the sample stage, and I'll just go to spot 3. I'll just pick one and I'll go to, say yes, and it moves. That's the point on the map. You'll notice that the core stages stayed the same, but the fine stages are based on where the map was. So if I go to the map areas and click on garnet spot 3, it will say that that pixel is at 183, and that translates to, that translates here, down here, it's this spot, which are these coordinates here of 415 and minus 2.35. In the X and Y stage coordinate system. Now if we go up and look at the fluorescence spectra for that point, we see the yttrium here, and it's still pretty high, and probably we're seeing, as we saw earlier, around 30,000 counts for one detector times 4, around 200,000 counts per detector. So we would want to do the yttrium SANES at this point. For now, because we have all these screens on top of each other, I'm actually going to move all of these screens for the map view over here out of the way, and go back to the Epic Scan screen and go to the XAFS scan. Now, for many elements, we'll have these predefined. So I'm going to say scan, read a scan definition, and we have a list here. But in fact, I have yttrium XAFS near the top of the list. So this will go to the yttrium, relative to the yttrium K edge. It will do steps that are in big steps, so 2.5 EV steps below the edge. Here's a molybdenum foil scan. And then fine steps across the SANES. And then for the XAFS region, we do this thing where we step in even steps in the wave number of the photoelectron, or in energy squared relative to the edge. What we're doing here at GSE cars is we're doing single time per point, and we're using continuous scan. It's kind of like quick XAFS in that the monochromator slews continuously, and so we have no overhead between points, but it's not very fast because we also have to move the undulator simultaneously. So we'll use continuous scans because it's better data and more continuous, but we can't go faster than about a half a second per point for a fluorescence at a count rate of 20,000 counts or so per detector. A second per point is going to be okay. And we could go longer, or we could just collect more data points. So we would be ready to start this scan. We're on the point we want to analyze, and we are near, so we could call this like yttrium XAFS garnet spot 1. We're running this, we call this running this by hand, spot 3001. And we could just hit start scan. I will say we typically have our scans, especially for XAFS, end in a number 001. And then if we do repeated scans, it will increment that number. That also makes it easy for the software to know to not overwrite scans. And if it has to, it'll increment and call something 002 if 001 exists. That's a good convention. But there's something I want to do before we start, and that is we took the map at 20.5 keV. And the yttrium k-edge is about 17 keV, 17.2. So I actually want to move the energy closer to the yttrium edge before we start the analysis. And to do that, I'm going to go to the command window, and I'm going to just type, we have predefined commands. We have many of these. I will show you these in a bit. We have one currently called move to Y, which will move the energy to the yttrium k-edge and do some optimizations of the beam line to make sure the intensity is good there. So it's moving some things, and it's, you can see up here, it's moved the energy to just above the yttrium k-edge, 17.125, about 100 volts above the edge or so. And then it's doing this dance of intensity and making sure the intensity is stable at that energy. It's not always vital to do this, but it's good practice to move to the edge before you do the XANES scans. If you're only moving less than a kilovolt or so, it's not vital. But one of the things that this will do is also adjust the intensity or the gain on the amplifier for I0, and then make sure that the offsets are collected so that the intensities in the ion chambers are accurate and have accounted for the dark current. So that takes a little bit of time. You can see the intensity dance, and then it went up, and then it went off for 10 seconds, and that was to collect the offsets. Now it's stable, and it's ready to go. And so we could just go down here and go back to XAF scans. This is defined, and we can just hit start scan. This will take about 5 minutes. So we're going to let this go, and we're going to talk about this while it's collecting. So again, I hit start scan. It says running. If I go back up here to the intensity view, it's moved below the edge already, and it's doing this check again of intensity. It seems like it wouldn't need to do that, but it does it for each scan just to make sure. It doesn't take very long for the pre-scan setup to work, and now it's going, I0 is stable, and now this is slewing along and it's collecting. Actually, you can see as it's going, the energy is just updating continuously, and the motors are spinning continuously. We defined this the scan to be in what I would call the normal mode of an XAFS scan, where it goes in large steps over the pre-edge, fine steps over the XANES region, and then in inverse angstrom steps over in the XAFS region. But we're doing this continuously. That means that those parameters are just used to define the speeds, the energy speeds or the angular speeds of the motor and the offset of control for the second crystal of the monochromator, so that this energy point spacing is simulated, so that every second it's moved the appropriate amount of energy and then bins the data. So you can see we're just getting to the yttrium K edge now, and I'm summing here. We have a lot of things we can collect that are collected in the XANES scan, but I'm plotting this what's called sum of yttrium K alpha, and that's the sum of all 7 detectors. It's actually the sum of all 7 detectors with the dead time correction applied. For each of the detector elements, we save the raw ROI, the uncorrected ROI, but then we also collect a dead time factor for that each detector. And you can see right now this has some noise in it, but that dead time factor is 1.16. But it's not being changed very much by the presence of yttrium. It's just that the presence of iron makes that detector about 17% dead. And so it's good to do that correction for the dead time. And the effect of the yttrium edge is not zero. It goes from 17% to 19%. It's not a big effect, but it's better to correct than to not correct it. So we correct each channel individually, and then add the corrected channels together. So that detector is a little bit more saturated, but not too much more. So again, we typically plot just sum of yttrium K alpha. And that gets written as a single column in the data file, and we can then interpret, then we can use that data file. So I'll put that away and we can measure this. So that's coming in. Of course, that's not only what we want to do, because we don't want to have to measure the garnet, the 5 points that we measured, we've selected from the map. We want to be able to scan all of those points. points. And we can do that. I'll show you how to do that now. So while the scan is going, in fact, I can go back to this commands and macros window. And you can see that we did the, it has a bunch of things that it did, including that we did this previous move to yttrium scan. In here, we could write text. So we could write, in fact, move to yttrium, and then hit submit, and it would then do that next. But what we want to do is to be able to write a command to, or a macro to do the yttrium zanes at all of the data points that we defined. And that's what we'll do now. We'll use this commands and then add position scans. So here, now this comes up. This is the list of positions saved from the sample microscope. And we can select any of these points and do a kind of scan. So we can do a scan that's either an XAFS scan or a map. So we could define a bunch of points and do maps at each of those points. So here we would do 1 millimeter map. That's the map that we last defined, set up to do the previous map. So we could say, go to all those points and do a 1 millimeter map. What we want to do is say, go to each of these points and do the yttrium XAFS scan. Then we have a lot of scans available. The one most recently defined was yttrium XAFS, so that's at the top. Which points do we want to do? Well, we could select all or none. I'm going to say select none, and then I'm going to say click on spot one and say all above highlighted. These are in the order, these are most recent at the top. So all above highlighted means all the ones that are defined since this one. And I'm going to say add commands. This won't do the work itself, but it will write into this macro the commands to say first move to yttrium, and then go to each of those points and run the yttrium XAFS scan. So these then scan, those commands we can then submit and run. And in fact, we could move to yttrium, or other elements, or say move to arsenic and do the arsenic XAFS, for example. And then this also, so this says move to garnet spot one, do the yttrium XAFS, do one of them. So you could alter this and say, I want to do three here and three here. But let's just leave those at one for now. The spelling does matter, and this is like interpreted as code, as like Python code. So this is important to get right. So that's why we have these commands to, these GUIs to help you generate the commands. There are other commands that we can also add here. So that scan is complete. There are other commands that we can add. If I go to commands and add other commands, then this window comes up with sort of common commands that we have. So in fact, move to yttrium was there. If I click on move to yttrium now, it will write it to the end. Again, it hasn't done this yet, but it's ready to be submitted. I'll take that out. We don't need that when we're done. But we might want to close the shutter. We might want to do something like close shutter. We could put that in. And again, this text can just be edited. The pound sign is a comment character. So if I go up here and write a pound sign in front of that, it will not do the move to yttrium. Since we're at yttrium, it's not a bad idea to start a sequence with that, but we could do that. And then we could also say move to molybdenum at the end, so that we move above and be ready for doing more mapping. So if I click on submit, so we might want to do that, but I think I'll leave that out and just close the shutter for now. This set of commands is also text, so you can save this commands, save this macro as a file. It's macro, I'll call this macro one. And that text is then, that's the text that's saved, and I'll hit submit. I'll hit submit, and we can go over and watch the microscope view. I'll minimize these, and it will move the microscope to each of the points. Did I hit submit? Make sure. It's going to move to each of the points, and then run the scan. You'll see that. I should point out that it added the comment characters here as it submitted it. So it commented these out as it submitted it. If we want to know what it's doing while it's going here, it's starting to collect the yttrium XAFS on spot one. We can also look at, from commands, we can look at show command queue. This is the set of commands that are queued up to be done. So first it's going to do spot one. These are the commands that we just entered. And in fact, if we had said, now that this is done, after it's closed shutter, maybe I should say open shutter. Spell that right. Again, maybe I'll just add that instead of trying to spell it right, I'll go to add other commands and I'll click on open shutter. That writes that in there. And then I'll say move to molybdenum so that we can go back to doing more mapping. Now that's done, I can close that. And we don't need to do it twice. It would be okay to do it twice, but we don't need to do it twice. And I'll submit that. I'll hit submit. And now those have been added to that queue of commands that it's going to do. With this command queue in place, we could also say, well, I don't want to do that one. I will cancel that. Cancel selected. That one's selected. That one's canceled. I could also say, you know what? I really wanted to open the shutter before, so I can take this out. I will not close the shutter, so cancel the close shutter. And that other one, those have been canceled. And then I'll say move this one up, or move that command to later. Say, and it will move that one in the list. So you can move the commands around, you can cancel some of them even while they're going. And even while scans are going, you can define and add more commands. So you could go back to the map. If I click on the map file, the map image, zoom all the way out, and move down here and call this, maybe I want to get a background yttrium. So I'll click on this point and say garnet background. Hit that. That shows up in our list. And now I can say, let's go to our command list, add a position command, select none, select just that one, and add that we're going to do the yttrium XAFS scan at that position two. That will write that in, and I'll submit that. And again, we define that point after we started this scan, but it's now in the queue and it will do that full list. So I hope that helps get you going on using the maps and the points saved to collect data and to be able to move around the beamline and be able to set up long queues. We hope that these long queues of data collection can help you collect data efficiently and not have to stay up all night collecting XAFS data. Okay, thank you.